1 month ago, I published a video on how to calculate exchange couplings using broken symmetry for these two complexes, a copper acetate dimer and a copper bipyridine mu hydroxo dimer. And the results I got were very underwhelming. The exchange coupling for the copper acetate complex especially was really bad. And the reason it was pointed out to me by a Redditor called FalconX88, who mentioned rightly that I should have optimized the structures. I didn't do that because I was trying to basically save time, and that ended up being a mistake. So I want to apologize first because I have misled basically the viewers of the video about what are the actual capabilities of broken symmetry. I wanted to show how broken symmetry is useful and ended up making it look bad as a not really good method. But actually, broken symmetry approach is quite good for exchange couplings, and I'm now going to show how to do it properly. And for this, geometry optimizations are necessary, especially for the copper acetate structure, because as you can see here, the crystal structure I used was from 1953, and it didn't have the hydrogens. So it's possible that this structure was not really very good, and that will result on a not really good structure that's not really close to a minimum. For the copper hydroxo bipyridine complex, the structure is better, and so there's not that much of a change between the unoptimized and optimized structures. Before I show you the results, I would like to ask for people who are not subscribed, if you are interested in these topics and have seen many of the videos, please subscribe. Also, liking and sharing the videos helps basically make them more widespread. So if you can do that, I would really appreciate it. I'm showing here the structural optimization. I use the TPSSh functional with a DEF2 TZBP basis set for some of the optimizations. For the copper acetate crystal structure on the left, there was no hydrogens. I put the hydrogens myself based on normal carbon hydrogen and oxygen hydrogen distances and angles based on other complexes. And the crystal structure has a copper-copper distance of 2.633 angstrom. And after optimization, you can see there's some change, but it's not a dramatic change. And the copper-copper distance has decreased slightly to 2.517 angstrom. For the copper hydroxo bipyridine complex, the relevant measure is the copper-oxygen-copper angle. You can look at the paper that I had referenced on the previous video about that. There's a correlation between the angle and the magnitude and sign of the exchange coupling. And you can see here that the crystal structure is not that different from the optimized structure. There has been a slight decrease of the angle to 93.36 degrees, and there has been a change of the nitrate groups forming intramolecular hydrogen bonds. This is possibly because the rest of the crystal, the packing, is not there. So that's one of the possible problems of doing a geometry optimization of a molecule that should be inside a crystal. That's one of the reasons I had not done it before, because I assumed that the crystal structure would not be very well represented if I allow the geometry to change. But luckily, it hasn't changed that much. In this table, there's a lot of results. First, the calculations that come from what I showed in the previous video, TPSSh, DEF2, TZBP. There are three values for each exchange coupling, and these are the formulas for this. And I'm going to use the third formula, because it is what makes more sense to me, and also it is what it is recommended in the ORCA manual. So we should only look at the last value, which is very close to the first value also. The mid value does not seem to be really explaining what's happening. So the first column is the unoptimized crystal structure results that I showed in the previous video. So you can see minus 84 reciprocal centimeters for the copper acetate dimer, when the experimental value was minus 315. And for the bipyridine complex, plus 110, when the experimental value was plus 172. This shows slightly that the crystal structure for the copper bipyridine complex was a better structure or closer to the DFT optimized structure. Now, on the second column, we have the optimized values. So we see here that the optimized exchange coupling for the copper acetate is minus 305 reciprocal centimeters, which is very close to minus 315. For the copper pyridine complex, it is plus 192 reciprocal centimeters, which is quite close also to plus 172. For me, this is good enough. I don't think that it is worth it to try to get a really accurate value, because that could be probably an accident. Also, I did some other calculations with different functionals to compare. The second functional I tried was B97-3c, which is not a functional per se, but a method developed by Grimm and co-workers, which is a fast version of the B97 functional that uses some special approximations, uses different corrections like dispersion corrections or basis set superposition error corrections, and uses a DEF2M TZBP basis set. So it is a triple zeta basis set, but it's somewhat minimal. It has been stripped down of some functions. So it's a smaller basis set than DEF2 TZBP. For the copper acetate dimer, I put here semi-optimized, because I use the optimized geometry at the TPSSh DEF2 TZBP level as a starting point for a new geometry optimization. This geometry was already good, but it was done with a different function. So these calculations were quite fast, but we can see here that for the semi-optimized structure of the copper acetate dimer with B97-3c, I have minus 530 reciprocal centimeters, more or less, which is near double the experimental value. And after optimizing the structure, the value even became more negative, so the description was actually worse. So it looks like B97-3c is not really very good for exchange couplings, although it's a good method for doing fast geometry optimizations, especially of large systems. For the copper pyridine complex, the unoptimized geometry, this is again the crystal structure, gave me plus 374 web numbers, which is more than double, and the optimized even larger, plus 405 reciprocal centimeters. So again, B97-3c does not seem to be good for exchange couplings, even with crystal structures or with geometry optimized structures. And in here we have the obtained values for the PBE0 optimized geometry with DEF2 TZBP, which is, this is a hybrid function. And for the semi-optimized structure, we got minus 184, which is around 60-70% of the experimental value. And for the geometry optimized structure, we got a slightly better value of minus 191 reciprocal centimeters, which is around, again, 60-70% of the experimental value. So that is not great, but also not that bad. And for the copper pyridine complex, we got plus 110 for the unoptimized structure, crystal structure, and plus 152 reciprocal centimeters for the optimized geometry. So in this case, it's closer. Still, the TPSSh DEF2 TZBP values are clearly better. TPSSh is a meta-GGA function. It's a hybrid functional, and it contains some measure of the second derivative of the energy with respect to the density. PV0 is a hybrid functional, but it's not a meta-GGA, it's only a GGA. So it only contains the first derivative of the energy with respect to the density. And B97-3c is actually, I think, a pure method. It does not contain Hartree-Fock exchange, and also it has a slightly smaller basis set. My recommendation would be not to use something like B97-3c or other variations of pure functionals for calculating exchange couplings. So my recommendation would be go to TPSSh, which is quite a good functional for these kinds of properties. So there are many other functionals like TPSSh, which are good for properties. And you can go see my video on how to choose a DFT functional, in which I show some of the benchmark results by Grimme. And usually, if you want to calculate good properties like exchange couplings, you should use hybrid meta GGA functionals, double hybrid functionals, range separated hybrid functionals, and stuff like that. And finally, just to show, I highlighted the values that we're going to analyze. We can see that optimization by TPSSh decreases the distance slightly, and the copper-copper distance, and B97-3c decreases the distance a little bit more, but there's not much difference in how bad the value is between the semi-optimized, which would be 2.517 angstrom, and the optimized geometry. So this does not seem to be only dependent on the distance. And for all functionals, the copper-oxygen-copper angle in the bipyridine complex slightly decreases, but it doesn't really change that much between functionals, yet the values are different. So it looks like it's not really a problem of a small structural difference, but a problem on how the electronic structure is described by each function. So I hope now I have shown how to calculate exchange couplings properly. Of course, you should always explore which functionals and basis sets are good enough for your problem, but I hope that this has been useful. Thank you very much.